Welcome to Cisco Training Videos. My name is Trevor. In the last video, we defined exactly what the internet and network was. In this video, we are going to specifically go in depth into one type of network called a LAN. So LAN stands for Local Area Network. And as you can imply from the name, a LAN is a relatively small network limited to a single area. Now, when I say relatively small, that's in comparison to the entire internet as a whole. Think of a LAN as a single network, and it's just one single network out of the millions of networks that exist on the internet today. An example of a LAN is most likely where you are right now as you watch this video. A LAN could be a library, a school, a home, or an office. Users on the same LAN can communicate to each other without having to traverse through the internet, since they can locally talk to each other. Take a moment to look at the diagram that I drew up below. This is an example of a LAN. If PC0 wanted to communicate to PC2, this can happen without the use of the internet. Since they're located on the same LAN, PC0 is able to directly talk to PC2 through the use of the upstream switch. However, if the users are located on different LANs, you would need a router in order for the users to communicate to each other so that they could be routed through the internet. Here's an example of that. If PC0 on LAN 2 wanted to communicate to PC4 on LAN 1, in order for this to happen, PC0 would need to communicate to its default gateway, and then through that router, it would traverse through the internet and connect to LAN 1's router. LAN 1's router would, at that point, route the traffic to PC4. An example of Ethernet could be LAN 2 in this diagram, for example. Let's say this was the layout of a small business's network infrastructure. Let's say somewhere inside the building they had a network closet, and inside that closet they had their router and their switch. The router and switch would be connected with each other using Ethernet. And switches are generally 24 or 48 port switches, so that's going to be each interface on the switch is going to be dedicated to one of the computers that are throughout the business. So PC0 would be directly connected to the switch using interface 1, for example. The next PC would then be connected to another interface using Ethernet, and so on for each host on the infrastructure. Whenever your switch runs out of ports, you would need to daisy chain another switch so that you could add more. At this point, you would be creating an access layer for your infrastructure. The other main medium that you need to know about for the CCNA certification is traffic traversing through wireless frequencies. An example of a wireless network would be an airport or a library. So an example of a wireless local area network could be a wireless access point that's set up inside a library. Inside that library, it's going to emit a wireless internet signal. Then the wireless cars that are inside devices such as laptops and iPads, those listen for that signal and they utilize it for their network connectivity. Versus the traditional Ethernet cabling, where if you have a device, it needs to be physically cabled to that device in order for it to get that internet connectivity. The advantage of using Wi-Fi, of course, is the freedom of mobility. However, let's say you're in the library right here, and as you walk away from the wireless device that's sending off that signal, and you start getting close to the perimeter of where the wireless signal is being sent out, as you cross that threshold, you're at that point outside of the wireless local area network because the signal can no longer reach you. The signal's faded at this point, so once you walk out of that area, your network connectivity is gone. Well, I hope LANs make a little bit more sense now at this point. Thank you for watching. Please leave any questions or comments you have in the comment section below.